So I will walk you through in this video, step by step, how to enable the Teams video interrupt service, Rail Connect for Teams, which is a qualified Microsoft service in the Azure cloud. It's geographically spread all over the world. Every data center is part of it, so it's high redundant service. And it's all in the cloud, so there's no additional infrastructure that you need to manage in the cloud or hire a CPU or memory or anything in Azure. No, this is completely one-off. You just pay for subscription and everything is part of it. Now, why we want to use the Teams video interrupt or Rail Connect for Teams? The thing is, there's still a lot of, as we say it, legacy traditional video endpoints out there. So we got SIP endpoints, we got H323 endpoints, customers has invested maybe in current Cisco endpoints and wanted to bring them into Teams. This is all in here. So the Polycom Rail Connect service really guides those customers with their endpoint into Teams. It's all based on a very familiar workflow. So as you will see later on, using Outlook, it's very, very easy to use. It's all in the cloud. So as a user, you can just take all the benefits of it. And of course, if you look at the pricing in the market of this service, it's very competitively priced for what you get for this service. Now, the nice thing is of this Rail Connect service is it's really a matter of you just press your whether your Skype for Business have or Teams have, you just press the same button you already have, and this will put the additional information as you can see here below in the presentation here. You see here it will push out the additional information here into the invite, and I think that is key. There's nothing as a user you need to do. You still schedule using Outlook your Skype for Business or your Teams session, or you use the native Teams app on your PC. That doesn't matter. It will push it out. And you can enable this for specific users, maybe during a trial you're doing. And later on, you can do this globally. But that doesn't matter. The licensing is based on your concurrent use of those endpoints dialing in. So you can enable your users and take benefits of this. Here you see the additional information, but also what is very important is the ease of use to join a meeting. So if this invitation is received by a trio or a group series, what you can do is you can provide this join button. And also, by the way, for a Cisco endpoint. So we have, as Polycom called in the cloud, one touch dial service. This is part of Rail Connect for Teams. So if you buy Rail Connect for Teams, you will also receive access to this one-touch dial service. And here you're able to provide the same Skype for Business or Teams invite onto a Cisco endpoint, which will provide you this join button, and you're able to dial into this service. And I think this is really a key benefit of using it from a user's perspective. So you really just walk into this room, and whether you scheduled your Skype or your Teams or any other invite, it's able to dial out into the service, and the users are able to do their work. And so don't have to think of the devices or anything. The technology should step out, and the people should be able to do their business as soon as possible. Now, what is available in this Real Connect service for Teams? Well, one thing is important, it's certified and supported by Microsoft. So this whole service is built into their data center next to all the other Office 365 services. So this is really key. It's all in that cloud with a subscription. You will get HD quality in this service. Bi-directional content, so you can walk into those rooms, Cisco or a Trio or a group series, and you're able to share content using your HDMI cable and share the content or from the Teams app and doing a desktop or application share. It scales in the cloud. There's even bursting options available. So if you got monthly, you got maybe a town hall session or anything, that's no problem. There are bursting licenses available. And you can burst if you want for one or two times. But if you want to do that regularly on a regular basis, and you really got 50 plus endpoints able to dial in, yeah, just get your bursting license. It's an optional license, additional to the regular subscription, and you can join from these benefits. Really, really powerful. Now, what is also a key thing before you start using this, or actually before you even start using and doing a trial, is make sure you can dial this number, 7357@test.plcm.vc. This is a room number which is available 24 hours a day for customers test. Because if you start testing Real Connect for Teams, it's I think approximately 60 days you can test, and after that, you need to go into a production. The extension is very hard to do, let me say it this way. So you really want to go into production after that. So make sure before you start a trial, you can dial this number from your endpoints inside the office. So you avoid any troubleshooting time for firewalls or dialing out to your video proxy or something. Very, very important. This service is available worldwide. As I said, you got free 60-day trial. So this is where I wanted to walk you through how this looks like step by step in this video. So you will receive two emails. One is a PDF file, which I will show you. This PDF file will contain the license to enable it. The license is based on concurrent use. For the trial, you will have a license for five concurrent devices who are able to dial in. So this can be in different meetings, or you will have five devices in one meeting. So it doesn't count the Teams devices who connect, the users from Teams clients or something. It's only the H323 SIP devices who will be dialing into the beat. And this is where your journey starts to activate your licenses. Here you go with sign in with Microsoft. And again, be aware you need to be global administrator to go in here. So first of all, you log in here with your account. So I will, for this demo, I will just log in as the user, so you can see all the steps. So here you see, this is my global administrator account. So I'm using a demo tenant now to show you that. We do next. And here we'll ask you for the password. Just type in your password. You say sign in. Yeah. So after successfully being logged in, what you will get is the consent. So that means, because Polycom Real Connect for Teams will add additional information to the invitations from the meeting. So what you will need is you will need to consent some information and access from the Polycom app into your data. And this is the consent on behalf of your organization. So this is why you need to have the global admin rights to make sure you're able to access that and able to put the information into the Outlook invitation. So we accept this. So now it will preload some information on the demo site. So you will see your Microsoft ID, the Microsoft domain. You can check that at the moment. There's no licenses activated here on this tenant. What you need to do is you go to activate a new license, and here it will ask you for the key that you've received through the email. So you go back into the PDF file and you copy and paste. You copy and paste that here into the license activation key. Put the actual red agreements and we say submit. So after activating the key, you will see that from today the license is activated and you got around around 60 days to trial the license. So that must be sufficient to test the licensing. You got a quantity of 5, so you can test this for 5 concurrent devices to dial into this service, and it is also the combination with Skype license. So if you request the trial license for Teams, you will also receive Skype license also for Real Connect for Skype, in case you you want to do the combination also with Skype. Today I'm focusing on Teams, which we can find here below. So the first thing is we need to do is we need to activate the consent for Real Connect for Teams. And we click on that. Here to add the consent, and we log in with the administrator account. And here you go, you got the permissions requested to add the consent, to join the calls and everything, and set up the meetings, which we will show you later on. We will say accept. And here you go. We have the consent successfully activated now. So this is the first piece of activating the trial license, and make sure that the service and the trial service is activated on the tenant. We go back into the web app.plc.vc. So this is where we activated the consent. The next thing we need to do is we need to activate using the PowerShell. So if you click that, you will see some predefined instructions here how to set it up for your specific tenant. So first piece is to connect to the Microsoft online service to enable PowerShell. Here you see that you can verify that the Teams video service policy is enabled. The next one is to configure your video interrupt service. So this will create the signature, which will be added into the instructions of when the user schedules an invitation through Outlook or through a Teams invite. And here you see the instructions how to assign that policy globally or specifically for a specific user. Yeah, so in case an HTTP or SIP device dials in, Normally, the user who is hosting the meeting will get prompt that somebody is waiting in the lobby to enter. But to make that experience better, so you can also enable bypass the lobby. So when they are then dialing into the meeting, they're able to wait in the meeting. So if the host is and doesn't have his laptop open to enable or to allow them, they're still able to access the meeting. So for some organizations, they requested this to have that available. Now, first we start with the PowerShell command. So on the top here, you see how to start your PowerShell. So you go into the Windows PowerShell, and here is where I enabled them into the tenant. So what you do is the first thing is you copy this one, for example, the get interop policy. You copy that one, you put them in here, and just to check if your interop policy is enabled from the Polycom side. You see that the policy is enabled, so that is true. So we have it licensed and disabled. The next thing we do is we configure the video service interrupt policy. So you copy and also this one here, it's really copy and paste into the PowerShell here and you say enter. And here you go. We enabled now the DAO instructions for into this tenant. Now the next thing is we need to do is we can assign this policy globally using this command or for a specific user. We go here, we copy this one, go back in here. Okay, and now we need to add me as a user, grant me access to that license. Say okay. So now I'll grant this user Janzet access, and now let me check if the policy was enabled. Check, and here you see now me as a user has granted now the RailConnect for Teams license. And what's good to know is it could take a bit before it is enabled, and that is more due to the sync in the Azure data center. Let me show you here. So if I schedule a meeting in my Teams client, let me give it a title, Teams meeting location. Okay, let me set it from 2 till 2:30. All right, this is a connect for Teams demo. We invite participants. So I'm also inviting here Amsterdam Trio, and you can invite some people. But I will also invite my Amsterdam Trio to show you later on how this looks like when you have a trio in the room, and how you can work with that to make it available not only in Skype for Business, but that it's also able to join Teams meetings. And now if we click schedule, what will happen? I think that is very important. You see you got the regular Teams information here on the top, but right below you see now here the additional information added to my invite. And as I said, that this can be enabled for all users, but maybe if you do a trial and you just want to use this on specific users to get familiar with this experience. But it's all the same workflow, it's all coming from the back end, so there's nothing on the client side exchanges, it's all there, and this will be added. Now, what is important is the first piece, the 7-11-98-9162, that is my tenant ID. That is fixed. So I can put that as a favorite if I want on my Cisco endpoint, or as I will show you here on my Trio, I can create a favorite for that, and people just punch that or dial that that speed dial or the favorite, and it will go into the service. And then the only thing you need to do is punch in the like meeting ID, because that is unique for every meeting. And what is also nice is that the Trio group series are able to parse it and show you this as a join button. So here you see the experience from the room side. So you walk into the room, you walk onto the Trio, and you see here your meeting invite, your Teams invite, which just shows you the join. So it's really just a matter of joining.
Welcome to Polycom Real Connect service.
Now, the other method, so one option is to join via the join button. The other method is, let's say you have maybe a sort of ad hoc meeting, and you walk into the room and you need to quickly dial into a meeting, is using the speed dial. And so here you got a speed dial into the invitation room. So if you punch that.
Welcome to Polycom Real Connect service. Please enter the conference ID followed by the pound sign.
And it's just a matter of punching. Now, as a final demo, which I wanted to show you is, if you're moving to Real Connect for Teams and you're going to use the Trio V Plus or V Pro with that, with the V Plus and with Skype for Business, you were not able to send content into a meeting. Now, using Real Connect for Teams with the Trio V Plus and also with V Pro, you can send the content into the meeting. So as a user, you just walk into the room, or as a guest or a trainer, if you put the USB here on the side of the Trio and you take this one and you put that into the laptop, it will prompt you for an app. So make sure you put this one into the side. Now an app will pop up on the laptop, as you see here. It will just load in memory, and you're able to share your desktop over the USB cable, but also send this content into the Teams meeting. So you click share, and here you go. You see now I'm sharing my desktop here into the Trio as a device. Now, there is one last item which I wanted to show you as a reference. Is when you start your journey with Real Connect for Teams, make sure you also review documents.polycom.com. It contains a load of information to prep yourself on this journey. So when you, for example, here go to cloud service, you go here on the left side to Real Connect for Teams administrator guide. There's a lot of information. So if you look for firewall information and the protocols that are used, the application that are used, here you'll find the test call information. And as I mentioned earlier, to do a test, verify your environment. So your environment requirements, so what you need. So as it mentioned here, you need Teams online, you need to have Exchange online, you need to have the global administrator to enable the consent, etc. So this is all very important. If you know that, you have that available upfront, it can save you a lot of time. Thank you for watching this video. Hope I've made you enthusiastic now to start your journey and testing with Real Connect for Teams.